In this episode of Star Hopping, we'll look at the Draco region, show you how to find these beautiful deep sky objects. Messier 102. NGC 5907. And the Cat Eye Nebula, NGC 6543.
All right, let's go star hopping.
Hey, hello, hi, and welcome to episode 56 of Star Hopping. I'm Dave Hearn, and I'm seriously jazzed to be your host. In this series of programs, we'll show you the most beautiful sights in the night sky and explain exactly how to find them with your binoculars or your telescope. Well, in last week's episode, we checked out three new comets visiting our solar system, and for two of them, we are looking into the constellation of Hercules. Just about 15 degrees to the left of the keystone of Hercules lies the head of Draco the Dragon, with its two bright stars, Eltinen and Rostabon, both shining at second magnitude. In tonight's show, we'll be checking out three interesting objects in Draco. One is rather famous, but it's a very tiny planetary nebula, and it'll require a larger telescope to be able to use a high magnification. The other two are galaxies, one very large and edge-on, and one that has been lost. Let's check out the large edge-on spiral galaxy right after this break. Star Hopping would like to thank our wonderful supporters on Patreon. Your contributions will allow us to create and provide more quality astronomy content. We appreciate your generosity and support.
Star Hopping target number one.
NGC 5907 in Draco is also known as the Splinter Galaxy. This is a classically edge-on spiral galaxy, a perfect example of what you see when you rotate a flat disk 90 degrees. All we see is a thin line with a nuclear bulge on either side of it. This type of galaxy is one of my favorites, although their face-on spiral counterparts are also pretty gorgeous. Astronomers think that this galaxy was created from the merger of several small dwarf galaxies. In very long exposure images of this object, there are some tidal loops that surround the galaxy itself. These are said to be the remnants of that merging event. So to locate 5907, we'll start from bright Eltinen, located in the head of Draco, just about 5 degrees to the left of the keystone of Hercules. Did you find it? Okay, let's get started heading toward the Splinter Galaxy. So let's move about 3 degrees upward to second magnitude Rostabon. This is a long hop, but it ends on a bright star. Move about 15 degrees to the upper left to second magnitude Eta Draconis. Now move 4 degrees to the upper right to 4th magnitude Theta Draconis. Now move 5 degrees upward and slightly left to 3rd magnitude Etasiche. Now move about 2.5 degrees to the upper right and you'll see the very large Splinter Galaxy coming into your wide field eyepiece. The Splinter is very large, spanning almost 13 minutes of arc in its longer dimension, and it glows at magnitude 10.3. It should be easy to pick up this one in almost any scope larger than about a 3-inch. This is an image of the galaxy that I took with the KPO reflector. NGC 5907 lies approximately 50 million light years from Earth. Well, earlier I mentioned a lost galaxy. Let's check out the lost Messier object right after this break. Would you like to see the scripts, images, and star charts that I present in each episode of Star Hopping in written form? Well, you can. They're available in our Field Notes digital guides that we produce for each and every episode of Star Hopping. Field Notes guides are available right back to episode 1 of Star Hopping, and you can put them on your phone or tablet to take with you out to your favorite observing site. Our field notes are available in our digital store individually, in seasonal bundles, or by subscription, where you can receive these useful digital guides in your inbox, sent to you the same day as when we publish each new episode of Star Hopping. Check out our selection of field notes in our digital bookstore by visiting starhopping.org/digital store.
Star Starhopping target number 2.
Messier 102 is one of the missing Messier objects that have not been surely identified. Its original discoverer, Pierre Méchain, claimed that M102 was a duplicate observation of M101, but there are historical and observational reasons to believe otherwise. It was suggested that NGC 5866 was a worthy object to fill this blank in Messier's catalog. This galaxy appears to closely match both Méchain's object description and the position listed by Charles Messier in his handwritten notes. Well, I'm convinced, so I'll go forward in calling our first target Messier 102. So M102 glows just a little brighter than 10th magnitude, and it's on the smallest side, measuring only about 6 minutes of arc along its long dimension. That's about a third of the size of the Splinter Galaxy. This galaxy has a bulging nucleus, and for this reason, it resembles a spinning spindle, and it's sometimes called the Spindle Galaxy. This proper name is also shared with NGC 3115 in the constellation of Sextans. We found that target back in episode 52 of Star Hopping. So let's locate the lost Messier object for ourselves. This one is simple. Based off our last position, it only lies about 3/4 of a degree straight up from the Splinter Galaxy. Again, from the bright star Eta Cygni, we're going to move about 5 degrees to the upper right to find a 5th magnitude star. Now move about 1 degree to the lower left, and you'll see the glow of M102, the missing Messier object, moving into your eyepiece. Like the galaxy that shares its proper name of the Spindle Galaxy, NGC 3115, 5866 is a lenticular galaxy seen almost edge-on. It lies about 40 million light-years away. Right after this break, we'll find a very small but relatively bright planetary nebula. We'll catch up to this feline seeing organ right after this break.
Hopping target number 3.
The famous Cat Eye Nebula in Draco is also cataloged as NGC 6543. This 8th magnitude planetary nebula is one of the brightest of its type. A 4-inch telescope will show a foggy blue-green disk about 18 arc seconds across, embedded in a fainter halo 6 arc minutes across. This is approximately half the size of the planet Jupiter, as seen in an eyepiece. So this thing is tiny, and it'll require 300 to 400 power to really see its disk. Its resemblance to a cat's eye is due to a series of gas loops that have been ejected by the central star over the past 1,000 years or so. It's one of the most complex nebulae known, but a large telescope is really needed to reveal its internal structure. The nebula glows at 8th magnitude, so it's not at all faint, but it's so tiny that you may just pass by it and mistake it for another star. So this is definitely considered a difficult star hop. So let's catch this little cat. Starting out again at bright Eltinum, move 5 degrees to the lower left to find 3rd magnitude Grumium. So here's another long hop, but it again lands on a bright star. Move 12 degrees to the lower left to 3rd magnitude Altaeus. Now double back and move 5 degrees to the upper right to 4th magnitude 42 Draconis. Now move about 3 degrees upward and very slightly left to find an 8th magnitude blue-green star. That should be our current target. Put in a high-power eyepiece and see if the star becomes a disk. If so, you've found the famous Cat Eye Nebula. In views from the Hubble Space Telescope, this nebula shows 13 concentric rings that form a bullseye of sorts, with a shell of nebula in front of it. Astronomers think that the star that created the nebula blew off layers of material in a series of pulses 1,500 years apart. The Cat Eye Nebula lies approximately 3,300 light years from Earth. So we've covered 3 interesting objects within our mystical constellation of Draco the Dragon. We started out with the massive and bright edge-on galaxy NGC 5907. That one hopefully jumped out at you when it moved into your eyepiece. It's very big, and the thin line is very easy to spot. Then we moved only 3/4 of a degree away to find the missing Messier object, M102. Finally, we located and stared into the Cat Eye Nebula by putting our highest power eyepiece into our telescope. So that does it for this week's episode. You can find the show notes on our website at starhopping.org/SH056, where you can comment and leave any questions that you may have. You can also contact me personally on Twitter at StarhoppingMan, where I'd love to help you with any astronomy or observing questions. So feel free to reach out with your questions. I'm here to help. Well, thank you very much for hanging out with me here. I thank you so much for your time, and I'll see you next time with more star hopping tips and tricks. Hey, thank you so much for hanging out with me here on Star Hopping. I publish new episodes every other week on Thursdays. Make sure you subscribe to the channel by clicking on the logo down there in the right-hand corner so you don't miss a single episode. And for some more star hopping content, visit my website at starhopping.org. You can click on this icon right here to visit. See you next time on Star Hopping.